We're back at it again with another Battlefront update. Another week and another weekly news update covering all of the latest news surrounding EA Battlefront. Again, we're able to say that we can start yet another week off with some more positive news to talk about. As not only have DICE dropped a brand new bug fix to the game, mainly thanks to a ton of brand new players who made them painfully aware that this was a problem, but EA also announced the actual number of players that arrived at a Battlefront on PC, and holy smokes, the number is absolutely insane and larger than any one of us would had anticipated. Now all we can ask ourselves is, what does this mean for the future of Battlefront? As always, we'll be covering all of this and more in today's video. And before we get into any of that, but a quick reminder, as if you do like these type of videos, then do remember to give it a like to show your support for not only this update series, but also the content within it. With that out of the way, let's get into it. So today's news update video is going to be a quick one, as unfortunately I still don't have some of the other news to share that a lot of you have been waiting for, like the update to the Unlimited Power event, or EA's current stance on breaking modding support on the Steam and Epic Game Store versions, and whether or not they're gonna be fixing that anytime soon. Now, granted, since last week more and more people within the modding community have figured out different temporary workarounds to somewhat fix that issue, but that's what they are, temporary solutions that do not always work and even require you to do them each and every time you turn on your PC. So until we get something official from EA on this issue, then don't expect an update on this for a while. That said, enough of the bad news, because we've got some good news to talk about, as believe it or not, DICE have once again been made to work back on Battlefront 2 and to give us something new by EA. And this time, being a fix for the XP / level reset bug. Basically, if you're unaware, this bug, glitch, whatever you want to call it, has plagued players for up to 2 months now, and has only today been finally taken care of. Both EA Support and Kevin Johnson of EA's community team tweeted out the good news, meaning that the situation where you previously sometimes had your high-leveled characters randomly and inexplicably drop in levels is officially no more. And this is something we can definitely thank all of those new players that joined the PC version recently, as without them, this would not be possible, as EA pretty much got so much complaints about this bug that they had no choice but to force DICE to fix it. And yeah, in the end, not only did the PC players benefit, but also everyone on console too, which is always great to hear. Now, in other good, amazing news, Battlefront 2 also broke yet another new Twitch streaming views record, this time hitting over 60,000 views on the platform and beating well-known game titans like CSGO. A feat that no one, absolutely no one, would have foreseen to happen in 2021. And yet we're somehow here, it's just insane. Not only that, but EA also today officially came out and released the total number of new players the game received last week. And let me tell ya, the number will definitely shock you. I mean, it should, because it did for me. But yeah, according to EA Star Wars, more than 19 million players joined the Battlefront last week thanks to the Epic Game Store promo, with even EA noting how shocked they were with so many new players coming into the game despite no more content drops. Honestly, what more can I really say here? 19 million players. Man, that's an absolute staggering amount of people. Like, we knew the game got a lot of new players to the point of EA servers were constantly crashing, but 19 million in a span of 1 week alone? Yeah, I don't care who you are, but that kind of number speaks volumes, and if anything, this better be a wake-up call for EA. Because if this doesn't make them realize the absolute goldmine they're sitting on with the Battlefront IP, then, man, I don't know what will. Until the next time, this will do it for your Battlefront update. As always, if you enjoyed the video, please like, share, and subscribe to the channel to not only support it, but also keep up with Star Wars news, gaming, and canon lore released every week. And consider following me on Twitter and Facebook to never miss out on the latest Star Wars content. Thanks for watching, and may the Force be with you.